Hi, this is Corey here, and we're here for another episode of Tuesdays with Corey. Unfortunately, this week, no one would talk to me, so I have to do another whiteboard session. So here we are, we're going to talk a little bit about SharePoint.
Yes, Corey, tell us about SharePoint and Windows Azure. I mean, obviously you can't save, 98% in the cloud with Windows Azure and MSDN, but just tell us what you do have.
You, in fact, can save 98%, Cameron. Great question. So, if you look at SharePoint today, and you hear a lot of people talking about SharePoint running in Windows Azure, if you run in our circles, you hear a lot of people talking about that. And, you know, a lot of people come at it with, hey, I have these sort of on-premise deployments, I'm going to go to Office 365, but, you know, I'm in the middle of that transition, etc., what do I do, right? And so for a lot of those folks, we typically start off by saying, well, you know, maybe leave your on-prem where it is for right now, but you've got 10, 20, 100 people writing applications on top of that on-premise solution that maybe you want to go dev or test in the cloud. And this is really where I think Windows Azure can really shine for you. So in sort of an example of maybe a dev test example, you could go up and spin up a virtual machine in Windows Azure that could have the entire SharePoint deployment running on top of one machine. Right, and this may be what you do on-premises. This may be how you sort of save machine space. You put them all in one box. Well, as most of us know, SharePoint would prefer, SharePoint as an application, it's alive, would prefer run across multiple machines instead of just one to get sort of a better performance story. And so if you're just spinning this up, and you're spinning this up in Windows Azure, now you can rent this space, because it is in Windows Azure, for a lot less, and get it, you know, going and coming as much as you want. And so if you're spinning up SharePoint, and you just do kind of a quick three-machine sort of deployment, you have your front end of SharePoint, and then you have, of course, the SQL Server in the back end, and Active Directory on both. And so you've got really a very simple, fast, easy way to get going with a SharePoint deployment. Your developers can go work on it. And when you're done, you just start deleting things, and you start over again. Maybe your developers messed it up. I don't know. I don't know who your developers are. So when you start building this, and you start saying, great, now I want to actually test it, it's so easy to just add additional machines. You start building out your actual full farm with high availability. You finally got maybe a middle tier for a search, or maybe you're setting up Yammer for this. And you can just grow it and dev and test and actually build out this full farm to be able to really run it for real. And that's kind of where your testing goes. And the beauty of this is just a simple 7-machine farm like this with SQL Server running in the back end, you can save up to 98% of your costs as opposed to running it if you use it with MSDN. And so the savings are great, it's easy, and SharePoint's wonderful.
Oh my God, that's great, Corey!
It's so much savings, says Mickey!
Thank you, Mickey. Thank you for joining me this time.
You're welcome!